The SRB nozzles have been moved to start position. Coming up on 10, T-minus 10, 9, we have go for main engine start. We have main engine start.
The Air Force is on the leading edge of technology.
We have ignition. We have ignition now for solid rocket booster and liftoff of America's Space Shuttle. And the Space Shuttle has cleared the tower.
Advanced technology, just in this century, has taken us far beyond our earliest dreams.
My name is Herbert Jefferson Jr. As Lieutenant Boomer on the television series Battlestar Galactica, I flew combat missions in the Viper, the most sophisticated flying machine in the galaxy. Unfortunately, the Viper only flew by the magic of Hollywood special effects. This month, Air Force Now takes you to Wright-Patterson and Edwards Air Force Base to take a look at another kind of magic. The magic of high technology. Low-level night flight. It's a new capability currently being flight tested at Edwards Air Force Base. The program is called LANTIRN, low-altitude navigation and targeting infrared system for night. And the test vehicle is an F-16. With LANTIRN, a pilot can see in the dark. He can hug the terrain in bad weather. And he can successfully acquire and destroy his targets. Director of the LANTIRN Test Force, Lieutenant Colonel Rich Engle.
We have three major components in the LANTIRN system: a wide field of view heads-up display, a navigation pod which provides us a FLIR image and plane following radar, and a target pod which provides us the capability to augment our conventional attacks. It really does allow us to open up the night window, opens up a new era of tactical air warfare. What's exciting about LANTIRN is the fact that we can go do many things that previously we could only do during the day, we can now go do at night.
LANTIRN. Remember the name. It's a new technology with a bright future. And so is the B-1 bomber. The B-1 uses sophisticated computers to link aircraft systems and simplify crew workloads. The result is a strategic deterrent that is reliable and versatile. Maintenance on the B-1 is sophisticated too. Modular components with quick fix characteristics save time. B-1 Maintenance Manager, Chief Master Sergeant Herbert Robinson.
I have an onboard computer on this aircraft called SETS that should do most of your real troubleshooting for you. You punch in certain codes, it tells you if an LRU, a line replaceable unit, is good or if it's bad. If it's bad, you pull the unit out, send it to the shop, and the specialist in the shop will repair the unit. What we're doing here at Edwards Air Force Base, at the Flight Test Center, is we're equipping the Air Force for the next 20 years.
Computers are a big part of that future. The integrated flight and fire control system installed in an F-15 test bed enables pilots to attack targets from unconventional angles. The pilot and computer work together to ensure success. A system called AFTI, Advanced Flight Technology Integration, is installed in an F-16. With two small wings added beneath the cockpit, the AFTI system opens unusual new possibilities for maneuvering and may become standard equipment on tomorrow's aircraft. One of the most unusual aircraft currently undergoing tests at Edwards is the X-29. X-29 test pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Ted Wiesbanowski.
It is a...
a good run. All test parameters for this time are often satisfactory. I'm Lieutenant Kathy Bailey, an engineer with the 3246 test wing. Our job is to take a validated weapon and test its compatibility with a proven airframe. After measuring the model characteristics on the ground, we then fly the airplane to determine its flight envelope.
Gator 5-6, loads 1. Gator 5-6, clear to accelerate to point 10, this will be 0.9 Mach, 20,000 feet. Pitch limiter is set to 3.5 Gs, and on condition, clear for the 360 roll to the right.
In this phase of validation, the aircraft performs a sequence of maneuvers that determine the stress limitations of an F-16 with the addition of AMRAAM's mass to the wing. G-forces are analyzed during flight from this control facility.
And the Gs. 5-4, 5-6, rolling. Pit maneuver 5-6, standby. All of our loads have fallen within our predicted values, and I think we've completed another successful test mission.
As the nature of the threat changes, so must our weapons. AMRAAM is only one of many programs that represents a renewed emphasis on conventional weapons. Under development are infrared and millimeter wave guided bombs, combined effects munitions and other dispensers. Runway busters. Modular guided and sensor fused weapons. Don't let the name fool you. These weapons are far from conventional.